because we are here as public servants to serve you. We are not here as bosses to dictate on you, upon you. We thank you individually and collectively. I can remember, is it Ansan Bai who used to call me?
Masai.
Yes. Every Swiss franc that you sent through Alassane has been received. It has been received by me, and I have also acknowledged by an official receipt, scanned and sent to him. You, as other Gambians in the diaspora, have contributed a lot to change. We have worked hard, and the only reason why God has helped us to really bring about change is a change in our attitudes. We started to work as believers. Believers, the majority of whom are from the Muslim community, anchored with our important peaceful correlations with our sisters, Christian communities and other denominations. We decided that we wanted change, and because of 22 years, the context which has really been described aptly by my colleagues, Honorable Ahmad Ba and Honorable Dr. Aissatou Touré, is a difficult and complex situation. This was the driving force and the inspiration of the coalition parties. Eight parties came together and decided to forgo their political differences and see embrace Gambia as an agenda. People in the diaspora also united, forgot about their differences, and supported the leaders on the ground. And because charity begins at home, our partners came to join us to help us. The change is here. And what we are starting as change is, first of all, after 22 years of a broken economy, a broken social fabric, infrastructure, communications, you name it, the coalition 2016 decided to adopt a democratic agenda, which is to reform the economy, because we found only 2 months budget support, which of course we know cannot pay everybody's salary and take care of the basic commodities or basic services. We decided to have a reform, a constitutional reform, that can allow everybody to see him or herself as a Gambian, and to have equal opportunity. We are working on that. We also have economic reform, where we are going to look at, already we have made some really achievements. We have been able to raise money, 60 million from the World Bank, 60 million from the European Union, and the United Nations system, the African Bank and Islamic Bank. Everyone is coming around to help us, to give us money for budget support, because we need to stabilize the economy. With the change, if people don't have the basic commodities, it is going to be really challenging. So we want to really stabilize the economy. We want to also stabilize the legal framework. We know that so many courts, so many cases have really been, so many people have been convicted, outside prisons, without the due process. So we want to really bring back Gambia as a human rights nation. And particularly within that framework, we are establishing a Truth and Reconciliation Commission, because we all know that the social fabric has been broken down. People were couldn't trust each other, brothers and sisters, husbands and wives couldn't trust each other just because of what we built. Now we want to really come back as a nation. And our guiding principle is here. We talk about constitution, but we must first of all look at our religious books, our holy books. We look at Christianity, look at Islam, what Allah has said, you have to wish your neighbor what you wish yourself. You have to be united. And we are very proud, we should be proud as a nation that we have got a national anthem, which is also the second guiding principles. Every day try to analyze what your constitution, what your holy book says and your constitution. And then from that you can walk rightly, you can walk as a united nation. We are very happy that you have associations, different associations with overarching missions, objectives, goals and objectives. This is what should happen. Circumstances compel you to come together. And we really acknowledge the support you are doing, because if somebody dies, which is very important, and you are not organized to help the person, the government